Hello, Red Raider fans, and welcome once again to yet another contest. This is Gary McNeil along with Keith Smith, and Carl King on camera. And we're going to bring you the Miami Trace London ball game tonight. This is the varsity game. And London's coming in here off, I think they're 1-1. Last week we kind of took, or Tuesday we took our lumps from Big Walnut, losing 87-74 in a really big game. Robinson ended up with about 22 points that game. And then we had some surprises with Tyler Hill stepped up, knocked in three threes in the last quarter, and Van Horn stepped up. So the coach has been searching for a combination that's going to make this team go. And I got a feeling those guys earned them some playing time tonight. You got anything on the Miami Trace team?
Well, last year Miami Trace didn't win a ball game, 0-21, so they went through a rough year. This year they're off to a 2-1 start. They've got about four players back from last year with considerable playing time. Among the leaders for them is going to be a fellow by the name of Mike King, who's a 6'2 senior. One ball game this year so far, he had 35 points, so, and he's averaging over 20 points a contest. So yeah, he's probably going to be the main guy from Miami Trace. They're trying to get this program going in the right direction. We saw from the reserve game they got some talent on the reserve team, and they got a fairly young varsity. So we'll see here tonight what happens with Miami Trace. I expect a good ball game. I think London ought to be able to dominate this team on the inside, but we'll just have to see how it turns out.
I know last year they were very high on their eighth grade team, and I'm not sure. I think they really come out with a winning record, their eighth grade, and they're all good-sized kids. And as we've seen, a lot of them already on reserve, so as freshmen. So they got a program that's getting ready to probably take flight any time. It should be a good ball game. Both teams are coming in with very little varsity experience. Lennon's only got Robinson, and maybe Buchanan had a little bit of experience last year. But other than that, Lennon's Coach Rone is starting all over again. So he's still looking for the combination. We got a ball game coming at you. If my voice holds up, stick around. Don't go away. We got a ball game coming. Don't go away.
Featuring the Panthers from Miami Trace High School and the Red Raiders of London High School. Now to honor this great country of ours, would you all please rise for the singing of our national anthem tonight being performed by the London High School cheerleaders under the direction of Miss Carrie Gray.
Cheerleaders.
Wasn't no baritone section, was there?
And they do it every year. She always comes up with some good voices. They get it down.
Assisted by Dr. Jason Hunter.
going to start out basically with about the same start lineup they had last Tuesday with Craner and Ungerman, Buchanan, Van Horn, and Robinson. I look for Hill to be in there fairly early in the game. Van Horn has been a big pleasant surprise. Like I said last week, Robinson was telling me before the season started that he thought that Van Horn would help him a lot. So,
I think this being the fourth game of the season for the Red Raiders, about time they start trying to settle in on some certain rotations of players. I mean, he's tried a lot of different combinations so far. So, this is a league game. London so far is 0-1 in the league, so this is a league game. Pretty important if London wants to hold on to their title.
Big man also jumps center, 34 King. So this ought to be a little more exciting.
Well, Miami Trace is coming out with a high-pressure defense. That's Mike King. Going to be a blocking foul.
Ungerman's going to get a foul on him, ain't he?
On Craner.
On Craner.
Blocking foul on Craner. That's Mike King. His older sister was an All-Ohio performer for Washington Courthouse in girls basketball.
She led us up quite a few years in a row. King gets his first points. So Trace draws first blood. This is a payback game, too, because London lit Trace up last year.
Well, they probably beat him twice because Trace didn't win a game. And I know they played twice being a league game, so 2-0 Miami Trace.
And two turnovers are off the bat.
Buchanan gets it back, finds Robinson.
And he's fouled. He's got to go up a little stronger than that for that shot.
Yep, that's Jacob Moore, 6'1 fella, put a block on him from behind. So,
Robinson will go to the line shooting two. He should have been able to throw that one down pretty easy. Of course, after watching the answer last night.
LeBron James.
Yeah.
He made things look easy. We talked a little bit earlier. The other thing, side of that equation on the other team, was a guy we're going to see at Ohio State for a couple of years, Ivan Harris. So he had a good ball game for Oak Hill Academy.
Yeah, he did. Well, we got 2-1, but London has no points on the scoreboard yet.
Yeah, well. Coming down quick for Trace. And they're not afraid to put it up.
Is that going to go against Trace? Because Ungerman was in there.
In fact, some of the scoring I saw in the Columbus Dispatch, you know, Miami Trace has been putting up a lot of three-pointers. When they beat Whitehall earlier this year, they had seven three-pointers. There's Ungerman shooting for three. Robinson fighting for the rebound. Knocked out by Van Horn. Yeah, King had 4 three-pointers, and Lovett had 3 threes, so they're not afraid to shoot from outside.
And we've seen that in reserve contests. They'll shoot it. Good steal by Buchanan.
He throws to Hungerman with a no-look reception.
These guys are little rugrats. They're all over the place. And number 23 is going to get a foul. I believe that's Marty.
Foul on Eric Marty. His first team foul number two.
I look for Trace to do a lot of what they did with the reserve contest, play kind of an extended defense, play an aggressive man-to-man, and that's working Hungerman to the corner.
And he knocks it down.
It's his second three-point attempt of the night, but one from each corner, and he nails the second one. So Miami Trace throws that one away. Martin trying to leave his man just a little bit too much.
Scores 3-2 now in favor of London. So London finally gets on the board.
Got Van Horn handling the ball up high.
Oh, we got to travel. Robinson got in there and nowhere to go. And all of a sudden he took off and forgot to put the ball on the floor.
Looks like London's going to go with a full court man-to-man press here.
He usually does.
Better get back. Nice job by Thomas.
Surprised they didn't call a kick on that.
Into Robinson.
And he loses control of the ball. Out of bounds to Trace.
Nice hustle by Brian Robinson, though. I mean, probably running one way and had to turn around and run back the other, but he beat everybody down the floor. London got the trap that they wanted. No-look reception there. Off of Marting's back.
Or it didn't go out of bounds, did it?
Must have.
London didn't look like it. I don't know what that call was.
3-2 ball game. London leads on Hungerman's three-pointer with 6 minutes to go here in the first quarter.
Should be a call there where they're reaching in.
Looking for Robinson underneath. And they've got three men collapsing on him.
Buchanan goes up before the shot, so foul's on the floor.
Foul's on Mike King, his first team foul number three.
We'll keep this going. At least we'll get to the foul line pretty quick.
Buchanan into Robinson. They're kind of in a man-to-man, but boy, they know that they're
Robinson.
And
it gets a little floater.
They were basically in a man-to-man, but I think the idea is when Robinson's got the ball, everybody stick a hand in there.
Yeah, you got to drop back in on him. Close up that middle.
That's King throwing a pass to Martin. Nice breakup by Tyler.
Tyler's showing pretty good hands here tonight.
Yeah.
Robinson's not catching the ball, or they're knocking it out.
This is Craner for three. Got his feet set. Nothing doing. Nice tip by
Hungerman. Goes two more.
Well, London gets back real good on defense that time, but then allows the man to dribble right through.
Or Willie Smith. Willie made a good one-on-one move in the back is here.
I thought that looked
knocked
like
it in. That's a good call. Had a blocking foul. Craner caught a knee that time.
We're seeing the aggressiveness of the Trace defense, just like in the reserve contest. Yeah, that's Trace's fourth foul.
And we're still got 4:54 to go in the first quarter. It'd be sweet if we get into 1-1 in the first quarter.
See, look at him sucking back in on Robinson every time he's got the ball.
No, that's automatic.
Yeah.
Lennon's got to spread it out, give him some room.
Yeah. Kind of working. Nice job by Robinson.
Good job.
Dish outside to Buchanan.
Buchanan gets give and go.
That's
here comes
Mike
Trace
King.
Right back at you. Hungerman with the rebound.
London's got numbers. Robinson sprinting the floor. He's trying to lean that one in. Hungerman gets
Robinson's got to keep the ball up, turn around and shoot it. Once he puts that ball on the floor, he's not a big man anymore.
Yeah, he's got 3 inches over top of everybody that's out there on the floor right now, so. They got King guarding him there.
London's showing a little patience here as Craner takes the line. A little too much muscle
nice
on that
move.
Shot.
London does a nice job getting back on defense there.
Makes the score 9-6. London.
3-on-2 London. Tyler
Buchanan. I like the way he used the board that time. Pulled up. Good follow through. Use that square. That's what it's for.
I think King just lost his concentration there for a second. He kind of got the pass in the middle, expected defenders on him.
11-6 is the score right now with 3:28 left in the first quarter. Lennon's on top. London has one team foul. Panthers has four. That could work to our advantage.
Miami Trace stays in their man-to-man defense.
London trying to bring
Tyler
Robinson.
Tyler give up his dribble too
way
quick.
Way to the high post now.
Trying to open up that middle. Buchanan tries a little jumper right there in the key, and we'll go for him.
That's Campbell on the rebound there for Miami Trace.
They've got to travel. Willie King. I don't know if that's Willie or Wiley.
I'd say it's Willie.
11-6 is your score. 2:50 to go in the first quarter.
Between Buchanan and Hungerman, I think that's pretty much all the scoring for the Red Raiders. Except Robinson's got a bucket and a free throw.
Had 13 points on the board there.
Nice. Oh. Timeout Miami Trace called by the coach. Just in time.
Hungerman nearly was out of bounds. He knocked out of bounds anyway, but he nearly had a steal. He set that trap up way deep in the on the court that time.
Well, I think London has done a good job tonight of trying to clear out the middle a little bit.
These two teams here are probably fairly evenly matched. Neither one of them's got an abundance of returning starters. And so fairly evenly matched right now.
I think really the difference in the ball game to London's favor, I think, should be the height factor that they have. But, you know, Miami Trace has a little bit better overall team height. You know, they don't have the big man inside, but, you know, they got a couple 6'1", 6'2 guards.
6'3", 6'3".
Probably going to present some matchup problems as the night goes on. Because London with, you know, Buchanan and Craner, relatively small at those two positions, but quick. Nice steal by Hungerman. He read
that. He's gone the distance. Net fan. Hungerman's got good ball sense and good court sense. And Buchanan comes back over hustle, and he picks up the foul.
Foul on Tyler Buchanan, his first, team foul number 2.
Tyler for Tyler substitution. Buchanan out, Hill in.
I told you we'd probably see Hill playing quite a bit tonight.
Also DeFilippo checking in for the Red Raiders.
So we got DeFilippo and Hill and Craner, Ungerman and Robinson in the, on the floor for London. 15-6 right now. Under with a little slight cushion.
Yeah, as this season progresses and with the players London seems to are coming to the forefront to play, this team's looking younger and younger all the time. Nice defense by Tyler.
Is he going to call Craner? Out of bounds.
Called out of bounds to Trace. 2 minutes to go here. London's got a 9-point lead, 15-6. This is King.
Drives. Try to get a little floater in. Just threw that one up.
He gets his own rebound.
He knows where the bucket is. Craner to the hole.
Nice move by Hungerman.
Not Craner, but Hungerman. I always want to call Hungerman Craner and Craner Hungerman. Good takeaway by Robinson.
There's
Hill. Hill gets called for a travel. Coach is on him too. That's one thing you know. If that coach likes you, he's going to be on you. So you can't take it as being picked on, but take it as being taught.
Something I don't think I've seen all year. Craner checks out of the ball game.
It's early in the year.
Yeah. Well, I was going to say, I think he's played 40 or 32 minutes each ball game so far. On the King on the top of the hill.
Big 5-0 goes up and it's going to go out of bounds to them.
It was off Matt Russell. The inside official didn't see it and called for help.
And Matt tipped it.
Looks like that's been Trace's game plan. They're trying to work Mike King, number 34, up around the top of the circle from the London zone.
He can tell he's their go-to person.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
5-0. Big Russ comes up with a rebound. 17-8, we're under 50 seconds now, first quarter.
Tyler Hill with the ball to Buchanan.
We got a relatively small team in there now.
Yeah.
A lot of backup players. Niner's going to be content to hold the ball. Hill pulls up on the side. Give him two.
Give him two. We'd give him eight if we could, but that's only worth two.
Makes it 19-8. Look out. Trouble. King.
A three-pointer?
Three-point.
What they're saying.
19-11.
Look, with only 12 seconds left here, somebody's got to recognize that. Buchanan penetrates, looking for Russell. Hungerman, you're running out of time, buddy. Tyler Hill, last second.
And it won't go. Coach, check coach out. He wants something out of that last few seconds.
I'll tell you.
Know where you are, know what the time clock says. So we finished the first quarter in 19-11, and it's on top this time.
You guys get it. London played pretty fair defense there in that first quarter.
Got Hungerman with 9 points leading all scorers, I believe.
Between Hungerman and Buchanan, I think Hungerman's got to be averaging in probably about 16, 17 points a ball.
He's been doing real good.
Teams are going to start looking for him. He might be able to surprise somebody early in the year, but they're going to start looking for him.
It's no surprise to me. I expected him to do that because he was. Probably could have moved up last year.
This is Marty. Just kind of working the ball around the perimeter, Trace is. Austin Bennett checking in there for the Red Raiders. Number 24, Craner back in the game. Good job by Robinson just to get his hands up.
And King gets in there and gets the rebound and puts it right back up.
Nobody else blocked out.
This King's got a good nose for the ball. He knows where that bucket is. Owls are catching up now. We got three and they got four.
Substitution for the Red Raiders, Buchanan and Russell just checked in.
I know Bennett just came out. Nanhorn, it looks like he might be getting ready to go in. So right now they got Craner and Russell, Ungerman, Robinson, and Buchanan on the floor. They've cut that lead now. It's only 19-14. So we got a 5-point game right now.
Van Horn checks in for Russell.
The only lead that Panthers have had was the first 2 points of the game. Since then, London's just taking over.
Pass is kind of two Red Raiders there. And here comes King out on the break.
Willie made a nice move. Just couldn't get to finish it off.
There's London trying to beat pressure with dribbling again.
That's what the dribble's for. He had two guys hawking him. He couldn't really see.
Yep.
If you pull up your dribble, then you're in trouble.
Well, somebody's got to come back and help.
I'm not going to try to second guess Coach Rona. He's got too great of a record. So I'm not going to second guess his coaching. Craner
takes it to the hole.
Hard.
Nice flip.
Big time. That's his first two, but that was a strong two. Makes it 21-14.
I'm putting on a little token pressure here. 7-point lead.
And a little touch pass there, moving the ball well. Hungerman had showed good strength there. They wanted to carry. Hill
gets his feet set.
A little strong.
Willie Smith.
Willie's pretty agile, isn't he?
He's pretty long in there. I mean, got him listed at 6'4", I think.
He's a junior, too. 6'5". He'll be back next year. That makes his score 21-16 now. London's still controlling the lead. Get in there and get you in trouble.
We'll call that on Willie Smith.
He almost had to call that because he just let one go just before that. Big time.
That was on Willie Smith, his second. Team foul number 5.
Well, Trace started out with a lot of team fouls, but kind of slacked off a little. They're only a team foul number 5 right now.
Got DeFilippo in there for Van Horn now.
London get into that one-on-one.
Filippo's got to show up on them boards. He's got that big body.
Robinson taking on 5 in there. Well, Gary, there's your confusing question
play
from last week.
You are where you were. He was inbounds before. And he was out of bounds.
But what if he jumped in the air? Then his feet weren't out.
He tried to, didn't he?
We're going to call Hungerman for a travel there, but London's doing a pretty nice job of moving the ball tonight. I like the way that they're passing the ball.
21-16.
London putting on a little pressure.
And we got a little less competition tonight, too.
Oh, yeah.
They're matching up pretty good.
King.
They try to isolate King, don't they?
Oh, yeah. They
let him go one-on-one.
Set up situations for him, and he took it right to Robinson. He wasn't afraid.
Robinson squares. Can't get her to fall. He's having a slow first quarter. We're in the second quarter now. 21-16.
Coach, that time 5 men from London was back. All of them were back.
They better be. They'd be in trouble. Trace tries to play an up-tempo game. They're always looking for King. There he goes.
Right there.
Boy's pretty smooth. He plays well without the ball, too.
Well, it looked like they're running some definite set plays for King.
21-16. King goes his
two-shot foul
to the line. He obviously had a lot of pressure on him because his sister was all everything at courthouse. So I guess he decided to go to Trace.
Well, actually, I talked to somebody before the game. The family lives in Trace. The dad is the freshman coach at Miami Trace, freshman basketball coach at Miami Trace. So it was his sister that had decided to ask Valerie that transferred to courthouse. Tyler
Buchanan for 3. 24-18. Tyler's stepped up to 9 points now. He got to pick up where he left off in the first quarter. But King made a move here and went split Tyler and DeFilippo like they weren't there.
Yeah.
DeFilippo, that's what I've been looking for.
Buchanan out to
Hungerman, he'll go shooting 2.
Kind of a hard foul there. I mean, it looked awful hard from Ryan Zimmerman, but he's just doing what he's got to do. I mean, you can't give up that easy layup.
I think the angle that Hungerman came across kind of brought that type of foul on. Good on the first one.
That's Hungerman's 10th point of the night.
He's on a roll. can't get the second one, and Buchanan goes over the back, and he's like he was saying, what did I do? That was too clear.
Lennon getting a little bit more aggressive here with the pressure in the backcourt. So. Trying to get Tyler Hill in the ball game. We'll check in for Tyler Buchanan. Maybe fouls Buchanan have. And down for two. So.
That's quite a jump for Tyler to go from a little bit of playing time last year on reserves at the end of the season to varsity. It's quite a jump. The young man's working for it.
Martin looking around for King, and this seems like to be their way they like to go about doing their business on offense.
He got to travel. He was getting away, though.
Definitely
King ought to get 50 points. He shoots every time he gets the ball.
Definitely seeing a trend developing here with the Miami Trace offense. In their win over Whitehall, they kept him down. He only had 11 points, but everybody else stepped up. Zimmerman had 19 points, and Lovett had 13. Bryan took that one dribble too far there, I think.
That was on Bryan Robinson, his first. He fouled six.
It's a new ball game for him. He doesn't really have anybody yet.
3-on-1.
25-20. Zimmerman knocks one in.
Well, Washington Courthouse allowed themselves to be trapped in that corner, but they worked their way out of it.
Got to use that ball.
We're going to call that on DeFilippo, but... Nick being big and strong coming across there. He runs into somebody. Normally they're the one bouncing away, not him. So kind of makes it look a little bit more than what it really was.
So we got 248 left. 248 left in that first half. That's ticket
number 5-5, 3-2, 9-7-7.
Well, I think for London, it's crazy stocking cap night in the student section.
Here we got a few people showing up. Bringing the band in helps out a lot, too. So we got 2:48 to go in the first half. 25-20.
Nice shot there by Campbell. Miami Trace keeps chipping away. There's another chip right there.
Down to a three-point game.
Saying off. Oh, Miami Trace doesn't like that call.
I thought they caught it in Trace's favor first.
Well, I don't think Hungerman could have caught the ball, and I think the way he reacted affected the way the officials called it. Hungerman acted like it was tipped, and he didn't want anything to do with it. And I think good job there by
Hungerman to react.
And Robinson up on the high post. See, they're in a 1-3-1 defense right now. They're kind of it's a 1-3-1, and I don't think London recognized.
25-22.
Oh, Campbell with the rebound.
We get another call.
Miami Trace's coach is going to have a heart attack down there, I think.
Coach wants a technical, don't he?
Yeah. You're going to get it. Do it while the opposition's got the ball. Don't ever do it while you got the ball.
They want to travel in.
London's trying to spread the middle a little bit, trying to work a little high-low between Van Horn and Robinson.
And it's kind of slowed up now. They're not as crisp as they were.
Well, Zimmerman's attempted 2 3-pointers in the last two trips down the court. Nothing doing.
Brian Pollock, the freshman's in the game for London.
Well, let's see if Courthouse.
Coach is still searching.
That's Mike King again.
1 point game now, 24-25. 140 to go, the first half. What are we doing?
Well, there's some advantages to having a big man out front passing the ball.
We're getting rattled.
But it does seem like we are a little rattled, maybe.
Trace can take the lead. For the first time since early in the first quarter.
Yeah. Definitely see him working a magic there from Martin.
Rebound by Robinson, big time. That's a big rebound there. He can't throw over top of these
right,
guys.
There's one of the situations where he talked about them having a little bit bigger guard. Well, that was a quick 10 right there.
I don't think so.
You don't think it was a quick 10?
He blocked the ball, then he got the ball and tried to dribble again.
Well, the big thing there I was kind of looking at is, you know, there's a situation where the bigger guards of Miami Trace kind of.
You got to go under them. You got to learn the bounce pass.
But somebody's got to come back to help. I mean, you can't.
We just stole the ball and then lost it out of bounds. And London's going to get it. Ungerman talked him into that one, too. He's going to be a politician, ain't he?
We're down under a minute.
Coach wants to hold on.
Trace is kind of in a 2-3, but they're looking like they're going to switch to man-to-man here. But there's Van Horn.
He didn't waste any time pulling the trigger that time.
I look for Trace probably just. They're going to try and probably take one last shot. Look for 34, Mike King.
Try to go in halftime with the lead.
They may take one sooner if it's open. Right inside, dump to Campbell.
Van Horn just mugged him.
He gets hammered. Campbell's 2 for 2 so far from the line tonight. He's got kind of a sweet left-handed shot.
We just dropped off big time in scoring at the second quarter. 6 points. Charles London's put up in the second quarter. That ball went across and
didn't get the roll that time.
Back across and fell off. Tie ball game. 19 seconds.
Let's see what London. They're going to step up the pressure on defense. We'll call one on King right in front of his coach.
And that goes in 1-1. So Craner will go to the line shooting 1-1. With 15 seconds left. Somehow we got to be able to get Robinson more involved in the offense.
Oh, the weather for. They're going to call over the back on Van Horn.
Van Horn's already got how many?
You know, when they're sucking back on Brian like they are, it just means he's got to work all that much harder to move away from the ball than back to the ball, you know, keep that motion going.
You got to get somebody who knows how to get the ball to him when he should have it.
It's a team thing. I mean, you got to set some screens. If you, move away from the ball and set a screen and come back to the ball, you'll get open eventually.
Looks like Trace has got the lead now.
Campbell's got a sweet stroke from
7-25. Hungerman.
Side of the backboard. Pollock tried to get the rebound.
5 seconds left. And
5 seconds. London better play a little defense here. That's plenty of time, especially the way we've seen Trace break his press.
Now, a while ago, I heard you say you can't go down the floor in 5 seconds.
Oh.
Did you or did you not say that?
Look at that one. I think somebody forgot to start the clock there. No basket there. So.
They waved it off. So, halftime score, 27-25, in favor of the Panthers. That's bad. The second half here. London's down by two. Trace didn't get that lead until the last few seconds of the half. They started out with the first 2 points and then they ended up two ahead at the end of the half. So,
who you got down in scoring for London there, Gary?
I got Hungerman with 10 and Buchanan with 9. Those are your big scores, leading scores for London.
And a big score for Trace, really. About the only one to put much up at all. Michael King, number 34, he's got 14 points here at halftime.
So I got 14 points and 25 shots.
Yeah. Well, you can definitely tell they worked the offense to him. So
see what happens here in the second half.
And then come out, start out with the ball because they deferred to defer.
Yeah. Oh, nice hustle there by Van Horn. And give that ball to Miami Trace.
It's surprising somebody didn't get a foul there.
London comes out with a little token pressure, but not a lot. London's going to go man-to-man. They're setting up the back door to King, and they're going to get Buchanan for grabbing his shirt, I think.
King took off back door. And the whole trick to that back door is to watch your defender's eyes.
Yeah.
And as soon as he looks the opposite way, you take off.
Just kind of tiptoe.
Already automatically got that step on him.
Make sure your sneakers don't squeak.
You got to jump on him. If he glances the other way, away from you, you got to jump
on
him.
Well, you got to be running an offense where you got room back there, too. Oh, somebody hits a Willie Smith, hits a four hard.
Yeah, that was mostly hand, I think.
Was it?
He slapped it.
Inside to Robinson.
Robinson's going to come out and take over.
Well, they suck back on him, and Van Horn's a lot more aggressive here in the second half.
Bodies all over the place.
King's going to take it 1-on-3, and Craner ends up with a rebound.
Ingerman pulled up his dribble. They wanted to travel. Didn't get the call. Hunter's got to get their composure back. We've done more of that. We've had at least four or five balls been thrown over.
Timeout London.
Way over top of the receiver. Coach Rone is not too happy with what he's been seeing here the last few minutes.
Well, Gary, we're going to do a little change on how we're doing trivia, or do we want to go ahead and run into that now?
Well, we forgot it. Really? What'd you have?
Well, it's something we kind of touched on a little bit last week, and we've got a little bit of a bonus question to it. Want to do that one?
Yeah.
Question tonight is most points scored in a single tournament game. And what year? Well, of course, we need the player and the number of points. And kind of the bonus, the kicker question, I guess, would be who's second on that list? That foul's going to go against Robinson, looks like. We'll give you a few minutes to think about that at home. And then
that was King. King just lowered his head and went to the bucket. When he come up, Robinson was over top of him.
Well, we played a minute and a half here in the second half, and so far, no results for either team. So, high screen for King. He looks comfortable just dribbling out there around people.
King makes a good move. He didn't pull up his dribble.
Yeah.
Just got him open for a shot.
Tyler Hill got that rebound.
But you don't like to see people dribble, so. Buchanan throws one in.
Nice job by Tyler.
So we got a tie ball game now, 27-27.
London trying to work the trap. Leaves Willie Smith open on the baseline.
And he socks it, he drops it in. So now we're going to trade baskets for a while.
Well, Smith had 13 against Whitehall, so
they're looking in.
Scoring.
Buchanan on the wing. No good.
King out to Willie Smith. Craner tried to draw a foul, and he did.
Willie didn't like it either.
Boy, I saw a look on Steven's face when he saw that big old fellow lumbering his way. It was kind of like, hit me, but don't hit me too hard.
And he tried to go to the side of him. He just didn't get far enough.
Well, Steven held his ground.
See, we got Hill in the game now for London.
I like the way London's passing around the perimeter there.
Count it.
Good job,
Good
Tyler.
Job by Tyler Buchanan. Buchanan goes in and does a little juke move in the air and gets it to fall, and he's going to line and one.
Well, there wasn't a lot of room on the inside there, but, you know, London working the ball around the perimeter creates a little bit more space in there.
Squeaky clean, man. I don't see how Tyler runs as big as his feet are.
I don't know how he got that shot through the trees, but he did it.
Nice shot, nice stroke there. London goes up by one.
30-29. Got a little shocking position there in the bucket there. Trace is happy just to throw the ball around the outside.
Well, London's playing a lot of help defense, or kind of in a man-to-man, but they're quick to slide off of their man to help where they can. There's
good
Buchanan
job,
sliding
Buchanan.
Off his man and helping out.
Buchanan got in the passing lane, deflected that ball, but it's still Trace's ball. 30-29, 4:54 left in the third period.
Ooh, nice steal by Robinson.
Here it is. He's been waiting for that. Maybe that'll get him pumped up.
Could be the momentum builder right there. Could
goes up by three now,
32-29. Oh.
That's got to be on King.
He's going to call it on Buchanan.
That wasn't on King over the back.
Coach Monet's a little upset, and I can understand why. The other thing, that's Tyler's fourth foul, too, which, you know, as hot as he's been, hate to have him have to come out of the ball game, but Pollock's going to have to check in. And apparently, they're going to call this a two-shot foul, saying King was trying to tip it in.
I had to see that one.
Well, check the replay on that one.
A soft roll there.
King's sister plays for University of Cincinnati, and she had 8 3-point ball shots the other day in a ball game. So, pretty talented family. Yeah, she made 8. I don't know how many she attempted.
She don't miss too many. That's probably going to Wiley or King. King. Nope, Wiley.
Called on Willie Smith.
I call him Wiley Smith. Willie Smith. 32-30. London's has a 2-point edge right now with 4.5 minutes left, third quarter. Pollock's in the game for Buchanan. Tyler Hill, Van Horn, Robinson, you got to catch that ball.
We kind of see the play kind of set there.
First thing you do is you got to catch the ball. Same as football, catch the ball.
Trace is trying to work King open on that side by himself, and Van Horn does a good job on him. Craner, nice hustle there.
They're trying to go over top of these guys, and they can't do it. I don't know when they're going to learn they can't do that.
Well, Martin's not that much bigger than Craner. In fact, he's probably about the same.
But you telegraph your passes. He's going to have to fake up and throw low, man. Bounce past the ball.
Fresh jerseys in there for Trace. For Jacob Moore and
32-30.
Checking in.
They jumped to the ball pretty quick.
Yep, and they jump on Robinson pretty quickly.
And walked away and gave him two
right there.
That was good patience on Robinson's part. Not panic, held on to the ball. Things opened up for him.
Well, the present Miami Trace lineup only has one player in there that's scored. King is the only one that's scored. All the rest of the players have scored zero for the night that are in the game right now. There's Marting.
Keep him in there.
Keep him in there.
34-30, London. Boy, when are they going to learn? When are they going to learn they can't throw that pass?
Let's see what London does.
Second team foul.
I thought they just called ball out of bounds for London, but they called a foul there. So. And Jacob Moore. Tyler Hill out top here.
Trying to force Craner to the middle. Craner's pass was picked off. Here comes,
that's King.
Green. Makes it a one-point game, 34-33. Count it. Robinson gets two and one.
And one if he makes it. We're not in one and one. Two for sure, one if he makes it.
Who's on the line shooting one?
Next time out, we'll get an answer to that trivia question. Should be a TV timeout coming up here soon, I think.
Yeah, we got to sell something. 36-33 now, 2:17. Still in the third quarter. King just went through everybody. Getting some ghost fouls in here tonight.
I know Miami Trace fans haven't been real excited about this group of striped shirts. But.
Well, they got six fouls on them. Right. We've only got three.
Well, same story in the reserve contest, too, but it was different officials, so might be style of play. Nice steal there by Moore. Good bounce pass. Oh, I'm surprised King didn't finish that. Russell got the rebound.
That's up. Pollock spots up. Hill under the bucket. He comes out with it. Good job on Hill's part. Mr. Robinson. Won't go. Pollock's playing big. He gets fouled. He'll be shooting two.
Foul on King there, too. So.
Pollock got real big in there.
That's four fouls on King. That's a big foul right there. Good job by Brian Pollock to take it to him.
Pollock didn't look like a freshman in that series.
Sink our free throws, that's going to be important.
Take it. 37-33. Got a four-point game now. London's up.
Get in there.
And Pollock gets the roll. That little soft foul shot. The boys learning fast.
5-point London lead.
If you want to stay in the game, you got to do something good.
Yep. He's playing good defense right now.
Got any scores in there right now?
Play more time.
Craner's going to get a foul. Going to get Craner body foul. Shooting two.
Trace relies so much on King to create the offense for him that they're in a situation right now. They got three players in the game and haven't scored yet. The other one, two in there, only got 5 and 2 points respectively. So they're faced with not having any scorers in the ball game.
London's got Robinson, Russell, Pollock, Craner, and Hill in the game. So, our big scorer Buchanan's out with four fouls.
And was having quite a ball game up to this point.
Yeah, he had 14.
Oh, ouch.
Oh, man, he went down hard. Looked like he hit his elbow.
That didn't sound good. He started to get up. Now, I'll just lay down for a second, Matt. There ain't no hurry.
Coach is working him too. Coach is working an official.
He's
good.
I have to catch a replay on that one. I don't know. Somebody really undercut him that bad? Or?
I don't know. He went down off a hard
one. Up and he was kind of trying to reach back for the ball. And
he went down hard, I know that. It looked like he fell on his elbow. That could make you go nuts.
Going to get rewarded here with a chance to shoot.
But he's not going to get a shoot. They're going to bring Van Horn in to shoot it for him.
Where did he even go? Did they take him to the locker room or what?
I don't know. Pollock.
Get in there.
Look at Pollock.
Man.
Look at Pollock.
Was Pollock about 6'7 or
6'8?
He's 6 foot in there.
He's
battling the big boy.
Playing big there. What coach is looking for.
Tyler Hill steps in there trying to help out on defense. And
Hill gets a rebound.
And London's kind of playing a man-to-man, except you've got to be able to step out and help your fellow player.
We've got a lot of underclassmen in there just right now. Harry got the bounce pass.
They're going to call him for
They're going to get a travel.
And you hear those sneakers squeaking.
As tall as he is, he could go right up where he was at and go over top of them and shoot that no easy jumper instead of having to try to force it. You're getting that close. That's not a bad shot.
Oh, Pollock again.
Take it. Get in there.
Van Horn's going to go shooting too.
A little bit of frustration there on Martin's part. But
yeah, he thought he was going to be able to knock it out on somebody's leg. And the ball just died right there.
Last week, we were really surprised with a couple kids. What about the play of Brian Pollock tonight, man?
Brian Pollock's doing a good job.
And kind of another surprise tonight, the ball game that Tyler Buchanan had up to the point of getting four fouls. I mean, he was playing excellent. Playing hard, great defense.
Well, we're almost out of the third quarter.
A couple of them fouls, you know.
London's up by 8.
Bad.
41-33.
London's in a little 2-3 zone. Kind of a matchup looking.
That was pretty. Kevin Scholl knocked that one in. That was pretty.
We got 8.5 seconds here, so.
Why did they call to stop the clock? Give them a chance to get the defense set up.
Steal by Marting. 3 seconds. He shoots from three. He's got it. Big swing right there.
41-39 already.
Gets him within two.
And we're up by 8. And 3-point shots, I hate it.
Well, he stole the ball and did all he could. Okay, tonight's trivia question, just so we can get an answer to this. Most points scored in a single tournament game. Who was it? What year and how many points? Well, Gary knows.
Had something to do with
it.
Yeah, what had something to do with that question we had last week? And it was Tony Simmons with 31 points. In the Clemens East, March 9th in 1965. But
the bonus question here is, who's second all-time on that list? And it's somebody presently associated with the London program, and that would be?
Kevin Long. How many have? 29 points.
29 points against Whitehall.
The 97.
JV or reserve coach.
Yeah.
Oh, they call it junior varsity anymore, or reserve,
JV,
or what?
Reserve, either one.
Oh, okay.
So Kevin Long he's second in line for most points in a tournament game.
Down on the London bench right now. So get out of the way if you want. See some more of our students over there coming out on a Friday night. Back to live action. Uh-oh, look out. Tamore. We saw that play running in the reserve game and it worked quite a few times.
They almost pulled it off. 5-0's back out on the floor, so he wasn't hurt too bad. This 8 point just disappeared real quick. Got Big Robinson way up top. Pollock's doing a good job of controlling his handling the ball and not getting frustrated and getting it taken away from him. Making good V cuts.
Nice lob in there to Russell.
Big two for Matt. That business 4-point lead. And we're going to get a foul. I believe it's on Pollard.
Looks like Miami Trace decided to start the fourth quarter without Michael King out there. So
that'd be my thought.
Here, Hungerman checks back in. He had 9 points in the first quarter and only's had one since. So let's hope Todd gets a little hot here, fourth quarter. Nice set play there. Courthouse runs a good set plays off of the inbound.
1-point game now. Hungerman for three, no good. So we got a 1-point game, 42-43. Oh,
I think he traveled, but
no call.
Willie Smith in there hits the deck, and Robinson gets a rebound. London's trying to find numbers, but
getting a little bit too rattled. So Trace had a bunch of people back.
Let's see if Hungerman can get hot. Nothing doing there. Foul away from the ball against London, against Russell, maybe.
Foul on Matt Russell, his second, team foul number six.
Apparently Matt must have been putting a little football move in there on somebody.
We only need one more on them, and we'll be in the bonus. Official called kicking the ball.
Oh.
1-point game, 43-42.
Game could come down to free throws because both teams are headed toward the bonus here. Well, London's already in it, but Trace will be in after the next London foul. Moore tries to hit that one.
Hungerman comes up with that rebound. That's a big rebound right there.
Oh, nobody on that side.
He should have went on to the bucket. Count it.
Will it count it? Well, I thought Steven had a chance just to continue on with that ball and take it to the hole, but he dished off to Robinson. Robinson's going to have a chance for a 3-point play here.
We'll take it, baby. No good. 45-42. Robinson just about got him a steal.
Nice attempt by Robinson. In there right now for London, Hungerman, Russell, Pollock, Robinson, and Craner. So
3-point game, 45-42. 6 minutes left in this contest. Coach is still looking for the lineup he wants.
You call out on Russell?
Yeah.
It's going to be his third foul. Who's going to make the free throws here?
Willie knocks one in. 45-43. Misses the second one.
Ball, but Moore gets the rebound. Then Campbell gets the rebound.
And Robinson's going to get a foul.
I got Campbell down for 5 for 6 so far tonight from the line. So Trace continues to go without King in the ball game. So we're going to save him for the last couple minutes. Of course, if you're London, you got to think about trying to get a foul on him as soon as he gets in there. Nice rebound by Robinson. Nice pass in there by London.
Pollock give him three. Pollock has stepped up big tonight. I'm really happy for him. makes it 48-46. Got a long way to go.
London's really stretching the defense right now, up by five. There's a nice steal.
Hungerman, he's on his way. And he's going to go to the foul line. And he's in the bonus.
It'll be a one-on-one situation.
Be two shots.
Oh, that makes it in the bonus, not just the one-on-one.
Right.
That's the 10th foul.
His third, he found number 10. On the line of shooting two,
still got to make them all.
Yeah.
48-43, London stretched out another couple points. We can take it up to seven. Count that one. And gives Ungerman 11 points for the contest.
Got
two people within double figures for London.
Yep. Too bad one of
them. Three, really.
Three
14,
of them.
McCannon,
too. Too bad he's sitting on the bench. He's going to be ice cold by the time he gets back out there.
Couldn't get the second one to roll. No bucket there.
Now 6-point lead now for Red Raiders. Stevie Craner slides in.
And look
there's King. He's back. Robinson.
Good job with Robinson. He's going to shoot two.
Now he's going to get. That could be the story of this contest right here. If London can take advantage of the free throws.
And that's what it's all about. You got to take score when the clock's turned off. And we got to make them. Robinson went up that time. That's one of the few rebounds I've seen tonight that he went up like he really wanted. He went up hard for that one. Oh, boy. He's 0 for 3. No, he's 1 for 5.
Ryan's got to start making these. There we go. 7-point Red Raiders.
2 for 6.
London stretching the court on defense. Here comes Campbell driving on Robinson. No call there.
He's got to go up with that shot. I don't know why he won't take that little jerk turnaround jumper.
There's Willie Smith taking it to Robinson. King tried to. We're going to call that on Pollock, I think. All right, London's got it.
Caught it on Russell.
I better check the replay. I don't even think Matt was even in there.
Didn't look like it, did it? Buzzy?
Carl, the cameraman, says yes.
He's got the smaller, broader picture than we have.
The smaller, broader picture.
Right.
That's King, like the bigger, smaller,
King has his
longer,
total.
Shorter foul shot.
He's got about 19 now. Oh. Under 4.5 minutes. 3-point game.
I got. Bonet wants a timeout. They walk?
I didn't see it, but it might have. We've got 50-47, and we're getting some mental turnovers there.
Yep. Well, Red Raider fans, we're going to be not going to be back for another home contest until next year. Next time to join us here at home will be January 10th against Columbus Whitehall. So, of course, then we have 5 out of the next 6 games at home. So, we're going to be away from home for a while, but don't forget the Red Raiders. Be playing down Circleville for the big tournament down there over the Christmas holidays. I think Liberty Union, Circleville, London, and West Jefferson. London's going to get West Jefferson in the first ball game, I understand. So.
I saw Kristen Holbrook in the crowd tonight. I don't know if we've had any shots of her or not.
Saw who?
Kristen Holbrook.
Oh.
She left here and went to Pickerington and played, but her mother and them helped us a lot. when they were here. And I followed their career all the way.
Quite a few through high school. Probably home on Christmas break. There's that long play again. They tried to go to King and couldn't get that one to work.
They're getting away with it too easy, too.
Trainer taking base on
it. And it was blocked.
Willie Smith in there.
Willie.
London extending the floor on defense still. 3-point lead. That's Zimmerman with the attempt there. He's going to go to the free throw line.
Who did that?
Now on Hungerman. Only his first.
Still a 3-point game.
Well, it'd be nice to see Tyler Buchanan get a shot to get back in the ball game here, but he's been sitting over there so long with 4 fouls. Probably all stiffened
up. He's coming off the bench now.
Now Coach Rone sending him back to the end of the bench again. So
he changed spots, so he's keeping him close.
Keeping him fresh.
Now we're back to a 1-point game. London 50, Panthers 49. Pollock, it don't go. Robinson, they're going to get over the back. They're going to get Robinson for going over the back. It's been a heck of a contest, I'll tell you that.
Been tight. Miami Trace got a chance to tie here. Now we're both teams are in the bonus.
Yeah.
That means 2 shots.
The rest of the way.
It's going to come down to free throws. Short on that one.
So they can still tie it. Tyler
here
Buchanan.
Here comes Buchanan.
In for Matt Russell. So we got Russell and Craner, Pollock, Hungerman, and Robinson on the floor for London right now. London's got 2 players out there with 4 fouls. Both Robinson and Russell are, you can't have 4 fouls.
Also 4 fouls for Trace would be Michael Smith. Michael King, I'm sorry.
Tie ball game, 50-50. That's the raffle.
Robinson backing in, looks good.
He takes it. Mr. Robinson puts London on top by 2. Here comes
King. Pass to Willie. Willie Smith. Foul on Campbell. Hungerman's going to go to the line.
Shooting 2. Bonus time. We got to make these bonus, man.
If these fouls keep up, we might be home by midnight.
We're getting a good time. It's only 9 o'clock.
That's Eastern
time. This ain't like football.
I'm on mountain time.
I wondered what was wrong with you. He kind of put a little English on that one. He leaned that one in, didn't he? It's good to see my cameraman smile. He had surgery yesterday, and I didn't know whether he was going to make it out here tonight or not. But he's here.
2-1 for Hungerman.
Makes 54-50. And Trace having trouble getting it in.
London's still stretching that defense, not content just to set back with a 4-point lead.
A good hands by Robinson to deflect that ball.
Robinson's paw out there?
Yeah, he deflected it. That could have been a layup there. 54-50.
Let's see what Trace does with the inbounds here. They normally run some set plays off of this.
Most teams do. I like to mess with you. Now we're going to do a little 3-man weave.
No, they're not quite looking to King quite so much. That's Marty right there.
They know we're looking to King.
Yeah, we're definitely.
Oh, good job of Ungerman just to control the ball. Yeah, those don't usually go.
That time King really couldn't play much defense there on Ungerman.
I think Buchanan just fouled out.
Who's the foul on?
I think it's on Buchanan. No?
Pollard.
I didn't even see him do it. 54-52. We're down under 2.5 minutes. It's anybody's ball game. Depends on who wants it the most. Well, Martin steps up. Big free throw.
Nothing doing on that one.
I almost give it back to him. I didn't see anybody getting no hurry, getting there and
get that rebound, was that?
Look at here.
You'll often see rebounds caught down around your knees, but Trainer got that one.
Yeah, he just barely got in the lane there, cut off the shooter in time.
Well, they're really packing in them back on Robinson every time they bring the ball his way.
Problem is, Robinson gets the ball, they're going to force him to make a foul.
Drive the ball right at King right now. I'd get the ball to Pollock and tell him to drive at him. Get him out of the game. Nothing personal, Mr. King, but.
Pollock's doing their freshman doing a good job. And Buchanan will go to the line. He'll be shooting too. Mississippi still got the touch.
How's Tyler Dunn? He hasn't shot any free throws yet, or has he?
No, one.
1-for-1 so far?
14 points at this point.
Better than being 0-for-1.
He's still the leading scorer. He set the bench almost half the game. Pretty much a whole quarter anyway. Boy, I thought that was going to be short.
Put nice arch on that ball.
Look, did it look like it to you, Carl? Then had it on there, huh?
Had it all the way, man.
I lost it on his rail.
Rebound by Campbell.
So now it's a two-point game.
Miami Trace takes a timeout. Minute 23 left to go with a two-point lead for London.
Trace has got to set up something big here. They probably want to keep the ball for a while. And some time off the clock. Probably looking to King to pull him, bail him out.
Carl's catching the crowd there. Not a huge crowd tonight, but big snowstorm expected. So.
It's a pretty fair crowd for the beginning of the season. And as we all know, you got to be winning to make the people come out. And it was only had like two or three games, so we don't know what this team's going to do yet.
Actually, it is kind of a little bit confusing. A couple different players keep stepping up, I'd say. I suppose last game we were really impressed by the play of Josh Van Horn and
Tyler.
Tyler Hill.
Tyler Hill. Pollock stepped up tonight real well.
I'd say tonight, Tyler Buchanan, of course, Ungerman continues to impress. He's done well. Robinson obviously expected to do well, so anything less than about 18 points from him, people probably consider he had an off night. So that's a lot of pressure on a young man.
He's got less tonight.
Courthouse seems a little relaxed here. Nice. Robinson gets his hands on it.
That's a big one.
London's just got to kill some clock here. Let them foul you if they want to. Try to kill some clock. Spread the floor. That's going to be on Marting. It could have been on King, but it wasn't.
Ungerman just about got stripped there. His chance to be a hero.
Craner's going to go to the line here. We got him down for what, 0-for-1?
Craner. I get them two guys mixed up every time.
Craner and Ungerman?
Why? Because I know Craner's got the little blonde spot on his head.
One's number 10 and one's number 20.
Yeah.
That was a big one right there. 3-point lead for the Red Raiders.
We need this one to force them into where they can't score on a 3-point shot to tie us.
Make it a two-possession game.
Two-possession game.
Unless you get fouled shooting a three and you make the three.
And it's still a one-possession game.
Campbell on the rebound. Look for him to look for King.
Mr. Hill's, King's got the ball.
It's like he'll try to spread the field, spread the court, not the field. Oh, King's shooting an off-balance jumper from three.
Jump ball.
Who got the ball?
London. 45 seconds.
Yeah.
45 seconds. This is going down to the wire. Now we got to make something happen here. Quick foul by 23. That's Martin.
Would like to say hopefully by couple games from now here, maybe London will have Derek Barkowiak rejoin the team. He's been able to come to the ball game tonight. He's still unable to play, so hopefully he'll be back in the lineup for him too. That'll give him another fresh face in there.
So now, am I right in saying Hungerman's at the line?
Yeah, that would be Hungerman.
Okay.
Steven Hungerman. No. Todd Hungerman. Not on that
boy,
one.
Oh, boy.
Still a three-point game.
Do we want this game or not? We got it. If he wins it, they're making him sweat for it.
Short again, he gets his own rebound. Take it up. We're going to call a foul on Pollock, I think. Willie Smith's going to go to the line.
A lot going on in his last 50 seconds.
That foul's on Hungerman. So. We said it, going to come down to free throws.
Free throws is killing both teams.
So we'll be out of here by midnight.
They've been making most of their free throws.
Not doing too bad. I'm not the best official scorer in the world, but I think I got most of them down there.
Yeah.
Missed it by
Willie.
That much.
You go, Willie. You the man. Now he can make it a two-point game.
Bet his knees are knocking on that one. There he goes.
He drained that one.
It's like Tracy.
We got a timeout. Craner looked like he got undercut there some kind of way.
Full timeout and a TV timeout for us. Uh-oh, London band's getting started.
Oh, man, there's a tomahawking. Some good shots of the crowd there.
Oh, yeah.
Mom and Dad look for their children. They said they was going to be at the game.
Yeah.
There they are.
See what happens.
Who's got the ball?
It'd be London's ball. Trace just made a free throw.
Next timeout goes to goes to Trace.
Your next jump ball?
Next jump ball, yeah.
See, London's got two timeouts left, and Trace has two timeouts left. So. Hungerman gets trapped right where Trace wants him. Buchanan gets it back.
He just barely got across the line.
Foul now.
And they're going to put Craner on the line. We didn't barely. Just barely did.
I don't love it.
Boy, we've had all kind of chances to put this out of reach.
Looks like Trace's plan was to try to get the 10-second violation on the back.
They were working on it.
And then once London gets it over, just foul.
31 seconds. That's a big one there. Can I call him Craner? That is Craner, right? Yeah. We need this one short.
It's short. 3.0 game.
They're looking for King.
Hungerman's all over King.
Down to 19
Here's
seconds.
King. He's going to try to spread the floor for him, I'm sure. It'll work a play for him. He's going to shoot. 13 seconds left. King on the rebound.
And Pollock.
Pollock.
Pollock comes up big. You go, boy. 8 seconds, and the freshman comes up with a big, strong rebound. Now just calm down and knock this one in.
Hey, before I forget, I wanted to give a quick shout-out to a couple guys that out there in my shopping center watch our games religiously.
Oh, do they?
Kevin and Timmy at the nail spa. So. Gotta have one here for London, make it a 4-point game. That's a freshman.
Pollock.
I remember that.
That makes him 8 points. Big 8 points. That was a big, big rebound there.
That's a freshman with ice in his veins there.
Coach told me earlier in the season he thought that he would help him a lot. And we got 8 seconds left, and London goes up 59-54.
Watching Brian come off the court there. I think he broke a smile there, just a little.
This is ours to lose. We got to, we can only, if we lose it, we beat ourselves.
I'll tell you what, that's ice in the veins, man. I can't imagine being a freshman and being in a varsity game. Well, I normally just can't imagine even being in a varsity game.
In a game, period.
I keep lying to you guys.
But
being a freshman and being able to step up there in a tight ball game and sink two free throws, and I said, I think I caught him smiling coming off the court there for a second.
He got a right to smile.
Oh yeah.
Up 8 seconds. Just put a little pressure on him. No. Just make them take a
good idea to use
a couple seconds.
Pressure. They're trying to pass.
That
was a hook and ladder there, wasn't it? Rebound.
We'll give Memphis 1 second left. With
that looked like a little hook and ladder there.
It looked like he's still in the backcourt when he got the ball.
Well, he was.
I hear the drums.
He was where he was. So the feet leave the backcourt.
That's where he should have been.
So he was where he was.
Looks like London can pull out a big win here. Make him go 2-2.
And plus it's the league game too, so it makes them 1-1 in the league, so.
Was Madison Plains, they're not in our league, are they?
Huh?
Madison Plains?
No, Plains is not really in, I mean, they're in our league, but they're not in our division, so it doesn't really count as a league game. Just division games count. They call you league champ, but you're really division champ.
1 second, I don't know what they, a four-point game, no long foul.
Just, there you go, just get it in and dribble it out.
And London comes up victorious, 59-56, on the wings of the freshman, Mr. Pollock. Folks, this is worth coming to see. These kids will give you their money's worth. Coach Ronay is going to make something out of nothing. You just watch and see. Just give him a chance. But we got to get behind him. Got to get the city behind him, the fans behind him. Because that is the mixture. 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th player. So we're going to give you a quick rundown here in a minute. Carl, I didn't know he was on me. I'm sorry. we're going to end up with Craner had 4 points. Hill had 2. Played a real good game. Arm Coleman with 13. Buchanan, a strong 15 in the first game. Van Horn ended up with 1. Russell with 2. Robson with 14. And the freshman Pollock, who pulled it out for us with 8 points. Done a great job by Pollock.
And well, for Washington Courthouse, we pretty much had just some balanced scoring here. I mean, other than the fact is that, you know, King ended up with 20. No other player for them ended up with higher than 8. Just want to mention about the London Red Raiders. I mean, it seems like every game it's somebody else stepping up for them, playing a little bit tougher. Tonight, I think, got to give a lot of credit. Tyler Buchanan, Hungerman, Pollock, you know, had great ball games tonight. Not to say that everybody else didn't play good, but, you know, that seems to be the story right now. Different people are stepping up and making it happen for the Red Raiders. So
that's the end of this year's contest at London here. So we'll see you next year. And this is Gary McNeil.
And this is Keith Smith.
And Carl King's right over there on the camera. And we're going to say see you, but I wouldn't want to be you. Adios. Good night. Keep the faith.
So London's just playing with 7 players here in the second half. So.
You can only play with 5.
Well, 5 on the floor at a time. They couldn't hear Carl. He's full of vinegar tonight. Martin bringing it up, and over to Schleister to Smith.
Smith makes a good crossover and
Jackson
inside.
Thought he had to rebound. Tips it out of bounds. Eight-point ball game here. Just too easy again, and Black has a hard time handling
that. He had a blackout that time because
London needs to.
He still could have got the ball.
London needs to pay attention on those inbound situations. They're going to give out to Trace. Somehow they're going to say Derek Eats just fell down all by himself.
Hey, we got to have a little better inbounds play.
Again, that goes into Martin. They look for Black at the key. Big man shooting a jump shot from the chest there. 43 seconds left to go here. 10-point Miami Trace lead. Ryan O'Neal checks in for Doug Jackson.
In the third quarter. Now we're even.
On one down there. Oh, that wasn't. He didn't take too much of a liking to that.
I think he could do.
Derek Eats throws it off of Cody Mallott, and Cody Mallott throws
Someone's
Derek Eats.
Someone's got to release and throw the ball along if they can't do that.
Brandon Boggs, not even set, trying to throw it up there, hits air. Smith on the fast break here. London's got numbers back. There's Marting, squares up, rebound Wheeler.
He's gonna challenge the big boys. He'll go to line shooting too.
But
he challenged them big time.
Fowl might be on Black there. Calling on Marting.
Seconds left in the third quarter. Diamond gets a point. They were stuck around 24 for quite a while. Yeah. 34-25.
10 seconds to go here. Martin just making quick work of Derek Eads out there. Eads gets called for the foul. Give him 2 shots. 9-point lead for Trace.
All that work, we've only got 1 team foul.
Well, that means either we're not getting them called or we're not playing aggressive enough.
It's
see if London looks to try to throw a little bit longer inbounds pass this time. Shot goes in. Trace is going to substitute in. London's got to recognize you only got 5 seconds. Can't dribble the length of the court in 5 seconds.
Oh, you can.
There's the set shot. Nothing doing there.
Had a lot of muscle behind that shot.
Fourth quarter, 10-point Miami Trace lead. And once again, inbounds play. Easy doings to Schleister. And somebody's sure not sure who's going to catch the ball there. So it's going to be Miami Trace ball out underneath their own basket here with a 12-point lead. London's going to man-to-man again. Trace is going to get another easy attempt. Okay, Cody Malott.
If you're going to go man-to-man, you got to put a lot of pressure on that ball. Just going to let him stand.
There again, there's Schleister.
He's got
nothing to it.
He just look at it.
Well, how many points is that for? I bet they got a 14-point lead. I bet they got 14 points off the easy baskets on inbound
plays. He shouldn't be allowed to pass that ball in that easy.
Timeout, London.
39-25.
London continues with their man-to-man on the inbounds play. And once again, another easy attempt for Trace. And they convert again. Wheeler inbounds to Sanders. Spencer Wheeler having a little trouble there playing point guard. Here's Smith with a breakaway layup. All at once now, we got an 18-point ball game here. Here we got our two. Trace with another inbounds opportunity here. Into Smith. We're running a set play. That's one. 18-point ball game here. What was it, 12 at the end of the third quarter?
Yeah.
Wheeler inbounds to Jackson. Trapped in the corner. Passes. He's out of bounds. Kind of Schleister lost a little control. Track where he was at on the court there.
Got where he was, huh?
London checking Brandon Boggs into the game for Doug Jackson. Well, Trace has played everybody, but there is one player still sitting down there and in no scrimmage time. So Brandon Boggs bringing it up. More pressure on the Eads. Eads finds O'Neal for the jumper, and he's got it.
O'Neal's been scoring when he gets a shot off.
He gets 6 points all night for Ryan O'Neal.
43-27.
I think Black just lost his concentration there for just a second. Trace checks a few players in. Trying to beat the pressure, and he steps out of bounds.
Looked like he's pushed out.
There's no such thing anymore. Used to be, back in the day when I played, there was what they called a force out, where if you push somebody out. But now, that rule doesn't exist anymore. This is Marting.
43-27.
Out to Schleister. Well, Miami Trace does a nice job of motion with their offense. Here they got a cutter Schleister. Ooh, Sanders does a nice job with the block. Schleister doesn't seem to care, though. He's just going to put up another one later on. If they block that one, I'll shoot another one later, make up for it. He's going back at Sanders again. This time he got it. He's got a scorer's mentality there. You can see it. That's Boggs into Wheeler. Passing up to Eads. 3-on-1 if he pushes. Goes for the three. Ryan O'Neal with his 8th point. This son Trace has got numbers. Nice. Eads ends up with a steal. Now London's got numbers. 4-on-2. There's O'Neal again.
O'Neal's hot. He knows where the basket is.
He knows how to get the ball in there, I'll tell you. He's going to get an opportunity for a three-point play here, maybe bring us back to a 13-point ball game here.
Just under 4 minutes left in the contest. 45-31.
And O'Neal going for his 11th point of the contest here. He'll be the leading scorer for the Red Raiders. He sank this one. A little short. This is your reserve contest.
45-31.
Miami Trace kind of spreading the floor a little bit. They've done a nice job of this all night. Ooh, rainbow.
Good shot.
That's Mossberger. He's a freshman. Another steal for Miami Trace on London inbounds. They miss. Eads bring it back up court. 3-on-2.
Bobby.
Where are they going to call
Sanders
here?
Going to score. And one.
Miami Trace's coach wanted a charge on Derek Eads there, so Sanders picks up his. You say that one counted? Fourth point of the night.
48-33. You know basketball is a game of runs, so it's time for us to make ours.
Don't need a big one here.
15. Ain't bad.
Officials there clarifying that foul's on 33 Marting, his fourth. Send Sanders to the line. Marting inside. It's Ingram around the lot. They look like set plays, don't they?
So is that your zone defense you're looking for?
I'm talking about zoning on the inbounds. You don't have to play zone all the time, but if your man-to-man ain't working, try something else, man. Wheeler inbound to Boggs into the corner where he's trapped. Ooh, need to put a little bit more zip on that pass. O'Neal ends up
on the foul line shooting 1-on-1.
Yep, team foul number 7 on Washington Courthouse.
Bill Jackson's getting ready to enter the game.
Well, now we need a 17-point run, Gary.
50-33. We can start it right here. 2 minutes and 45 seconds left in this contest.
Into the ball game right now for London. We got Eads, this is O'Neal at the foul line, also Doug Jackson, Bobby Sanders, and Garrett Hotchkiss. 11 points now for Ryan O'Neal.
Yeah, I wonder if he's going to call that.
So you're only allowed to dribble the ball once, huh, Gary?
He dribbled and caught it and turned around and took off the other way again.
Eads and Jackson trying to break pressure here, dribbling and dribbling and dribbling. Into a trap.
They took him right where they wanted him to go.
Yep, a lot of times with a defense like that, they want you to step right across that half-court line at the corner up there.
Coffin corner, they call it.
They call a five-second violation there.
Getting that coffin corner, you're dead.
2 minutes.
Like that 5-second call seems sometimes a little arbitrary, you know? I mean, you see other times when there's dribbling and they're deep close on defense, they don't call it, but then.
You got a break there.
Sanders kind of lowered his shoulder there, and that's what got him the foul. Nice save by Doug Jackson.
They're going ahead.
Yeah, we got a little pushing down there. And Sanders and Ingram. So.
Scores 50-34. Like I said before, there's only a couple of these kids that have any reserve experience, so it's a whole new team.
Trace does a nice job breaking pressure. Morton to Ingram. Derek Eads is in there, pestering at him, but gets the call. Minute 53.
To 34.
We got an inside foul there on Malott trying to get position.
One-on-one.
Yep. It used to be they used to have something called a backcourt foul where you didn't get to shoot the one-on-one. That was back in the day when I was playing again. If you was fouled after that 7, if it was in the backcourt, you didn't get to take it. You just had to take the ball out. It wasn't considered deemed as bad of an offense, I guess.
Dragging
so.
The game out.
There's O'Neal with his 12th point of the ball game.
He's just about a lock to be a high point scorer.
Unless we go on that 15-point run.
Be nice, wouldn't it? 1:45.
Definitely a night to remember for Ryan O'Neal. 14 points. He'll call that on Derek Eads.
I didn't see that one.
I kind of thought that was a little ticky-tacky, but I think that official was just, I think he's trying to send a little message to Derek here that he didn't like the arguing on the last call, so to give him another one for good measure. This is Smith. Miami Trace finally drops pressure here with 1:30 to go in the contest. Of course, with the clock not running right now, probably
still not running.
Probably makes it. Oh, now it's running. Eads gets a ball back. We got a scrum going on. White ball.
Picked up about 10 seconds on that last.
Well, he pointed. He called white and he pointed toward black, and it's going to be black ball here. Bounce to Smith, back to Marting, being hawked by Eads. Looks like Trace is just going to be content to spread this around and timeout black.
Better go in.
Minute 8 left to go in the contest here. 14-point Miami Trace lead. Looks like Trace is just going to be content to keep the floor spread here. Clean jerseys in there.
Had everything going for them and they turned it over.
Inbounds pass to Jackson who gets it to Eads. Dribbles through pressure. Finds Sanders. Sanders is so. Thought he was fouled, but no call there late in the ball game. This time they're going to get to Eads for the foul. And that's probably just about going to do it for him.
He's only got two. They had it wrong. Now they're still showing three.
I don't know what the call was, but
the board says he's got three.
Oh, okay.
The player foul says he's got four.
But it's not in the 1-on-1 yet, so. Doug Jackson on the fumble. Going sport, huh, Gary? Did you see the way he dove at that thing, though? Reckless abandon. He forgot he left his shoulder pads at home.
We used to have a drill like that when I was on reserves. They ended up doing away with it. Two guys dove head and knocked each other out.
London having a little trouble there.
7 seconds.
Well, London needs to put this one away and just forget about it. Analyze what they did wrong, but you're just going to be content to dribble it out.
And we're in this contest. Miami Trace 50, London 36.